Hello, hello, familia. Welcome. My name is Magda and Janet. If you are new, welcome to the fam. Please don't forget to like and subscribe because we're always here. Having a good time and come visit me on TikTok and Insta because I'm there daily. And of course, welcome back to my oldies, but goodies, you guys. So I'm experimenting with my skin today, and that's why I didn't show on camera what I'm doing. But what I did was added this halo glow in the middle of the face and then cream contoured with this, the deeper shade, and then went over with the foundation. I think it looks okay. I think it could look better. I'm gonna try it out again. This is what the base is looking like. I haven't put my concealer on because I want to start off with the blushes. So Kofi is a brand, a fairly new brand at Sephora, and they released blushes. And I was like, ooh, they look so pretty and very vibrant. So I want to try them out. You guys know, do a wear test and everything with these bad boys. So let's see. I got two shades, Pinky Promise and Lucky Lotus, which is purple. I love purple blush. I think it looks so good on people of color. So let's open these up. They come in this tube like this. I'm gonna use these little brushes because I do have a small face. What the hell's a net here for? Okay, so on the left side, we're gonna use the pinky shade. Looks, wow, this thing's pigmented. Oh wow, look at that. Whoa, it's very hydrating. I don't know, you guys know how I feel about hydrating anything. We got oily skin, so let's see. This is pigmented. It has this lightweight, kind of moussey, kind of creamy, something like very in between that it feels. I hope it's not too creamy. That's the only thing I'm kind of thinking about. The new Kofi Mendy Moment Long Lasting Radiant Cream Blushes retail for $28. I have the shade Pink Positive and Lucky Lotus. These are highly pigmented and long-lasting buildable cream blush that blend seamlessly into the skin for a radiant flush of color. Highlighted ingredients is amla extract that is rich in protective antioxidant to fight against free radicals, hibiscus extract that hydrates and moisturizes the skin. I purchased mine at Sephora. On this side, let's go with the pink. Let me add a little more, and then I'm gonna grab my Real Techniques brush. This is the setting brush, but because it's small, we're gonna try it out right here. My foundation has been on the skin for a little bit, maybe like, I don't know, 15 minutes now. Oh, it's adding nicely on top of the foundation. It's subtle. Is it buildable? Let's see. And I like to add any cream product onto my hand and then blend it out. Let me get the other side. It's getting too pink here. Oh, that's pretty. It's not lifting foundation or anything. Okay. And then with the sponge, if it's a little much, we can kind of just go around and blend those edges out. Actually, let's add a little more pink here. It's swatched extremely creamy, but on the skin, not that it's going matte, but it's not going on as creamy as it is on the, oh, you know what? Because look, it dries. It dries down quick. It goes on creamy and it dries. Okay, that's what I'm getting at on this cheek. Okay, so that's good. Drying formulas when it comes to like something creamy like this is good because it kind of adheres to, well, it adheres to the skin. It'll stick on. And because we have oily skin, we need things to stick all day long. Ooh, ooh, ooh. See, the purple looks purple, but on my skin tone, it kind of gets to like a purple pink. Huh. Ooh. Oh, she's pigmented. Oh my God. Hold on. You kind of have to work fast, but not like too fast. Just semi-fast. I just like to add blush everywhere, especially when I'm reviewing it so you can see. Okay. I'm gonna get my foundation. Wow, I got this as a mirror. I'm gonna get my foundation brush and kind of get the edges. Also, I haven't put my concealer on, so that's gonna help too. Settle it down. Okay, let's color correct a little bit. Blended out the concealer. It looks so pretty. Look at this. I love this purple. And look, It covered up my janky foundation splotch that I had with that with the Halo Glow because I messed up. And then this is the, ooh, this is pigmented. And it looks good after concealer. You see how it just like settles it down? This side has more. Let's kind of, I don't even know what brush I used anymore. Do you guys know? I think this one was the pink one. Oh yeah, this is dry. Well, no, not dry. It's like, yeah, a little dry. Yeah. Okay. I hope this was the pink blush. Not blush, brush. And then you can always just like, you know, get those edges like that. Like doot doot. Like the brush will always give you, you see how it gives good pigment? And then you can also just settle it down. Ooh. And then, ooh, looks good. I'm kind of like thinking it's better than the Charlotte Tilbury one in the wand. It's definitely more pigmented. You will get that pigment right. But I'm curious to see how it's going to last. I'm gonna get my purple, a little bit of purple, and just add like that. Yeah. Okay, and then with my spongies, I'm gonna blend out my under eyes and whatnot. I'm gonna get some of my Maybelline in, what shade is this? The fair one. I like to set my under eyes with this one because it's really light and then it provides a nice little highlighting situation for us. All right, like that, like that. Huda Beauty's pink powder is back in stock, so I'm gonna use it. That's why I haven't been using it, because it wasn't in stock for a while. I hope it hasn't sold out. Okay, and then with this powder, I'm going to set to the rest of the skin and just go on top of that cream. Although the cream is low-key kind of dry now. Also, if your blush is a little too intense, your cream blush, powder, going on top of it with powder will tone it down as well. See, it's not as vibrant, it's not as dark, but wait, you can still see it though. These swatches, like, they're not gonna move. I'm gonna show you them right now because I'm really, 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 hold on, my nose is all jacked. Okay, the crevices look not good. I want to kind of go over with powder blush. Should I? I probably won't, no. Okay, let me tell you the time. It's currently 6:53 in the a.m. Let's see how it's going to last on my oily skin. I'm just going to finish up my face, just add eyeliner, you know. That's it, really. I'll be back. Oh, wait, before I go. Look. Ooh! Ooh, this purple is so pretty. On my hand, I did want to show you, look. It moves, but it's kind of like stuck down also. Like it's not matte either. You see how it keeps that hydration? Anyway, I really like that. Okay, be back. These blushes, I really, really like these. I definitely think they're a lot better than the Charlotte Tilbury one, the wand. I'm just like in awe. I feel like they have the same idea. It doesn't say that it's matte, but it kind of dries down matte. I didn't really wash my hands, so I can show you how it's still pigmented and like stuck to the skin, but it doesn't feel dry. And it has this moisturizing, hydrated, stuck down, adhere to the skin feel, you know? I didn't add any powder blush because I'm like, you know what? Let's just see how it works out. I just love how this looks. And it's buildable. It's not too heavy. It doesn't make you look super like clowny. And it's workable. You guys saw how we were looking clowny and I got, where's my sponge? I put my sponge away already. You guys saw how I got my sponge, just kind of dabbed it and it worked out. So I'm loving these. I hope they last all day. You guys know we're going to do an all day wear test. Hopefully it does. Typically blush tends to fade, especially because if you have oily skin and big pores, like it oils and things start to concentrate here first and then it kind of just blends away and like fades. But I'm kind of liking this. And you guys, my lip combo is this one again. I just like it. It's Captivated and Total Baller from NYX. Let's go outside so I can show you how the blush looks and see you later. Bye. All right, you guys. Oh, the sun. Okay, this is the blush. You see the pink? And you guys, look, I washed my hands and it's still there, at least the pink one. Look, looks so good. So pigmented. I love this purple one. It is so pretty. But yeah, I just want to show you in daylight how bomb this looks. I just love like the subtlety of it, but it's pigmented, you know? So let's see how it lasts. Hey, Leah, I'm back. It is, what time is it? It is 5:30. We've had this blush on all dang day, but before we get started, I do want to show you how the cheeks were looking at around 3 o'clock. Honestly, looking really good. You see both pigments of the Pinky Promise and the Lucky Lotus, the purple blushes. I feel like they look very much the same how we left off. Here we are, many moons and hours later. You guys, look, this purple, I love it. I just love how it's purple, but it has a little bit of pink to it when it goes onto your skin and the pink. My forehead kind of went away. I do have oily skin, so my oils are kind of just taking over. But you guys, I really like these. These are so good, so cute, so lightweight and pigmented without peeling, creating patches. I think these are really great. Have you tried Colfi before? I did review their concealer a while ago, and I'm just happy to be back with some more makeup. And these are bomb, like pigment. Oh, love it. But anyway, let me know your thoughts. Are you planning on picking this up? Have you seen these? And this is it. I love you guys so much. Thank you for all the love and support you always show me. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, click the button right there, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.